good afternoon, everyone. Not a good time slot to talk about technology stuff. Half the audience is anyways not there. But let's just go ahead with this. Pretty interesting topic, something that we all know about, something that we all use, but let's just give a different perspective of it. So let's just talk about numbers first so that, you know, we understand the trend and, we'll relate use cases to it on how this is different. We've all know that there has been a digital transformation which is going on. There has been disruption in terms of location technologies coming in terms of the push that the government has given towards this particular industry. And the numbers have been increasing. So it's remarkable to see that the digital transactions have increased multiple folds over a period of, I think, around 18 months after the demonetization. So the figures that state somewhere around 3 billion transactions which will be happening on a digital platform by 2021. We have that data. This is the expectation. The banking industry, as such, the insurers, they've been growing. It's very important for us to understand where this transaction will be coming from. So India is digital. India is more digital now than ever. There are around 35% of adults in this 2000 compared to 2011. We have around 80% which has bank account, and most of them have started using a banking product or more like an internet banking services or wallets or pockets or different technologies for making payments. India has not restricted itself to more of a traditional banking which is there, and with respect to that, I'll be focusing on areas on how location can be of vital importance. So, there are a lot of predictions about how 2018 will keep seeing an uprise in terms of the digital medium, in terms of collaboration of fintechs and banks, and how it's becoming disruptive in terms of technology engagements, partnerships. But what does it mean for a bank? Let's just take a look of what we have as an industry, what kind of goldmine we're sitting on. So there's a lot of data that we have in terms of customers, what they do. Mr. Anurag has spoken about all these fintech trends in the first session itself. We're talking about chatbots, we're talking about security. At the same time, we're talking about moving to cloud, we're talking about blockchain, there are smart workflows, personalization. So all of this is something that we've been discussing of late, but what does it mean for a bank? Artificial intelligence, it's a broad technology, it's a broad term. But where can you apply that artificial intelligence? So as Mr. Mahapatra rightly pointed out, that it's the incremental innovation that leads to something which is great across all use cases. So how do you get that incremental use case, incremental disruption? So, we've kind of proposed, so India has an India stack which is there, right? And there's consent, there's cashless, there's paperless, there's presence, and we propose a location layer on it, right? So this is what we'll be talking about. So let's just look at what kind of data we have, what kind of goldmine are we sitting on in terms of a customer base. So let's say there's this guy from Nagpur. He did his schooling from Pune. Moved to Bombay, for a job, stays in an HNI locality, does procure some financial products, has a bank account, does some mutual funds, visits ATMs, bank branches near, shops, just see what kind of data. So let's say this is where this guy lives, it's called Raheja Classic. These are the nearby, amenities around where this guy stays. This is the neighborhood data. For example, so let's say if you have one guy or some customers in an area, you can actually start collating it and collision with partners like us to understand how this particular neighborhood looks like. And, he stays in Andheri but works somewhere in Worli. Beech mein Prabhadevi jata hai. This guy goes to Siddhivinayak Mandir. There are a lot of retail joints around there. He goes there, he eats. These are the areas where he kind of shops during the weekend, which is very close to, this is Infinity Mall, which is very close to Raheja Classic. He owns a car and, he also has a vehicle tracking device inside the car, just in case for a security or a safety purpose. So what do you capture from a customer like this in an urban scenario? You have his residence building, you have the branch details around him, you have the agent details around him or the relationship managers. You know the assets, what he's procured. You know what kind of retail stores that he's going to, the demographics around, the distancing. So all of this is something which the customer is trying to tell you that what he's doing around 24/7. So Mahapatra sir was talking about, crowdsourcing. The crowd here in terms of the banking space is the customer itself. The customer every time talks to you in terms of a transaction that he does anywhere. Now the idea is how to use this data constructively to bring about those digital technological changes. Let's talk about something which is rural. This guy is from Dive. This is a very nearby village from Pune, which is around 30 kilometers outside. There are certain bank branches or ATMs around this particular village. Post office zyada hai wahan, but there are a lot of post offices. So traditionally, payments and deposits and everything used to happen via the post offices. There's still a lot of post offices in those areas. This guy is a farmer and he owns a plot of land there. So this is another dimension which you kind of capture in terms of a rural. So when you have an urban attribute, you also have a rural side of it. The field, the dimensions, the kind of vehicle that he owns is absolutely different. Using all of this, we're talking about achieving the fintech, the map trend that we're talking about. So all of these next-gen technologies we're talking about is something that can be powered using maps. Let's just hold on to this slide. So bahut intelligent baat hai, kali intelligent artificial intelligence, we're talking about chatbots, we're talking about personalization, we're talking about blockchain. But what does it mean in layman's language? We're talking about operational ease, we're talking about consumer use cases which kind of delights the customer, we're talking about planning on how to reach out, because there's physical, there's digital, but then there's something called as phygital, which is kind of a combination of both. The panel discussion, it was being, someone said that, there is absolutely no way that we are doing away with the branches, because someone there would always like to know that, hey, there, we are there, any problem, you can come back to us, right? So that's something that involves a lot of planning, a lot of machine learning on where you put up your branches, where is your customer, how you can move around your brand, basically. And then you have sales and credit. So all of these use cases put together, chahe aap usko artificial intelligence bolye, you talk about blockchain, you talk about chatbots, you talk about, in terms of machine learning, you talk about micro marketing. It's all of these are powered by maps or location. Location is extremely important. You already have this data in terms of what your customer is doing, where is he spending, where is he traveling, what kind of car he drives, how much petrol does he consume, because he's definitely, if it's an urban customer, he's using a card for all sorts of payments. If you start mapping all of this, you'll already have an entire universe of data with yourself. And where we play a role here is providing a map. Right, it's a map API which is compatible to all platforms, which can be consumed for different use cases. For a map, you can have maps and traffic, you have search, you have routes, you have telematics. So all these plugged together in a single platform provides a host of APIs, right, which can be plugged together, which can be played around with, and this is something which is a very good alternative. Implementation flexibility as well. So what we've done here, interesting is, so traditionally people are talking about cloud solutions, moving to cloud, agile architecture. But at the same time, when you start putting your customer data in a cloud, which is where the data is going outside of India, you're actually doing away with your own IP, which you should not be doing. So this is something of a security concern that people are trying to address here. And the other way around here is that we have a flexibility to deploy the entire map content on premises. So this gives you high availability, this gives you direct control over the entire infrastructure that you have, and it takes care of the security guidelines. There's a lot of other data sets which are available in the market, which we have, which can be consumed in terms of driving that artificial intelligence factor that we're talking about. So for example, let's talk about the chatbots. So today, the chatbot responds to what you ask them, right? The specific set of questions which are defined. Let's understand a scenario where the chatbot knows where I'm talking from, and the chatbot responds and promotes certain products, which the chatbot knows that the customers in this area where I'm talking from has already bought. So the probability of me buying the same thing is much higher as compared to a random response, a FAQ or a Q&A which is happening. So this is what artificial intelligence is. We talk about fraud management, we talk about fraud prevention. So every time a card is swiped, you get to know where it has been swiped, basis the address. You know the address, you map it out, you know the customer's presence with respect to the registered mobile number. You match the distance and find out whether it is beyond a certain range or not. That's artificial intelligence. That's how you do the preventive fraud maintenance. So all of these use cases put together, you know, comes across as a disruptive technology, disruptive, you know, disruptive transformation which is there. Another piece of information which is very, very critical in today's world is that we're talking about digital, we're talking about cashless payments, we're talking about cars, we're talking about bitcoins, a lot of other features. It's very important, if the guy in front of me, if the Kirana store, which is right opposite my house, if they are not using a digital payment method, I'm bound to give him cash, right? So I have something called as a merchant universe where I can give you geotagged photographic images of entire merchant list which is there. City by city, lat long wise lat long, and photograph images, which can be a goldmine for companies like you, which will be more used for any kind of products that you want to pitch. For example, your SME loans, for example, POS machines, for example, wallets. You know, so this is what, so this is how it looks. This is how we capture data, this is how we develop, and this is how we kind of license the data sets. So as a company, a quick snapshot, this is what we do. We've been around since last 25 years, great association with companies like ISRO, CRAC, Indian company, Make in India, and you know, we've been developing this IP for a while. You know how the addressing in India works. It's very typical, you know, different geographical structure, different addressing mechanism throughout the city. There is no standard hygienic way to write an address. You and I can write address in different ways. So we've tried and integrated all sorts of permutation combinations under one single API algorithm, which kind of helps you with all those permutation combinations of addresses that you get. This is a kind of example of the kind of detailing that we have on the maps. Right, we've integrated weather data. So anyone around talking about whether a crop insurance or a crop loan is something, you know, this can be made use of. You have the historical weather, you have the live weather, and you can do predictions around it. Right. This is something, another interesting point. In the West, Europe, and UK, and even Singapore, there are zip codes which are there, which is a six-digit code which takes you directly to the flat number. There's nothing as such in India. We've been trying to create something like that. So we call it as an e-lock. The e-lock is individual for every door number. So for example, a geographical lat long of a building will remain constant irrespective of whether it's a 40-story building or a 100-story building. What we are trying to do is for every flat which is there in a building, every house number, we have a separate code for it. So this becomes like a digital footprint or like an Aadhaar of the addresses. This is how we put it across. And I already spoke about this. You know, the government of India has given a great push in terms of the India stack in making things online with the eKYC piece. You know, let's just start using the location layer to have that digital or the physical footprint in place. And let's just start using the data which is already yours. Let's not put it on cloud. Let's not push it out, you know, to people and then again put efforts in buying it. And just map your future with MapmyIndia. So that was all. I think I am still left with 12 seconds. So thank you so much.